Alright, hey guys, welcome back to The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild. So we are currently going through a maze to try to get one of those spirit fragments. Oh no. Okay, I am going the right way. Okay, good. I thought there was like a dead end here, and I would have been so mad. But I'm just looking at the map and trying to navigate through this very elaborate labyrinth of a maze. It's pretty awesome. Okay, I think I may have screwed up here. Oh my god. Oh my god, this isn't the right way. No way. Are you kidding? Surely this has to be the right way, right? No? Dead end, dead end, dead end, dead end, dead end, dead end. Aw, man. I went the wrong way. I picked the wrong path. I cannot believe that. I didn't look it up. Oh, wait. Did I go this way before? I don't even know where I'm going now. Maybe this is the right path. Okay. I thought I got scared there for a moment. I thought I went down the wrong path. I would have had to backtrack a long ways. All right, so we're supposed to go up and then take a right and then take. I still feel like we're going the wrong way. I don't know. We'll just keep going until we hit a dead end. I don't know what I was doing. I was wanting to see if I could smash all the enemies over there, but that obviously isn't working. So I need to bring it back. Okay, then I can just leave it over there. That was really dumb. This is the longest freaking puzzle ever. I think I'm going the wrong way. This is a dead end, but I want to see what's over here. Is it a dead end? That's a ladder. Whoa, there's multiple floors to this puzzle? No way. Unless we made it to the center. Wait, fire arrow. I could go up the stairs, but I just want to wait a second. See if I can't see anything up here. I don't see anything, but I don't think I can climb, right? Oh, I can climb. I didn't know I could climb. And we just made it up another floor. Oh my god, this maze is ridiculous. The Great Flame Blade. Attack when the blade glows red to expel flames. Nice. We just found a secret weapon. How about that? This is really cool. Like, this is the coolest maze I think I've ever seen. Just saying a whole lot since I don't really do a bunch of mazes, but this is really cool. I feel like once we get to the top, we'll get to the shrine. Yep, we're here. We did it. We freaking did it. Yes. Whoa, that puzzle. Man, that was crazy. Real quick, I'm always curious, like, is there anything behind here? No. It'd be really clever to hide something behind the shrine for like the few people who are curious enough to see. Oh man. I've been playing for like maybe like 3 hours straight. So getting a little tired, a little bit cramped up. Trial of the Labyrinth. So that maze wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be, but I think it could have been a lot worse than what it was. I think I just got lucky and picked the right path. I think there is two correct paths, honestly, but yeah, I'm just happy I got a freaking flame sword. That's awesome. Flame sword. I wonder if there's another sword on the other side. Might have to check. You've proven your worth. Yeah. I'm also curious to see what the treasure is. It's always pretty awesome to see what the treasure is in places like this. A barbarian helm. Attack up. A helmet once worn by warriors of an ancient warlike tribe from the Faron region. Wearing it draws out your inner animal, increasing your strength and battle prowess. Sweet. So this gives you less defense. A lot less defense, but my attack goes up. That's a pretty cool. And it gives me like red hair. That's cool. That's worth it. I love it when we find clothing, because clothing doesn't degrade. Weapons and shields, they go away like that. Just like, you use them once and they're gone. But clothing lasts forever, so I'm really glad we found some clothing. And we found another spirit orb. It's the first one that we found since we got a heart container. So that was fun. I mean, I don't know why I decided to just drop everything and do a crazy maze, but I'm glad I did. That was cool. Oh, it's just really cool looking at these Joy-Cons. I don't know why. They're just interesting looking because they're colorful. I'm so glad I got the red and blue one instead of the other type. So before I do anything, I want to go down here. And I just want to... Whoa! Okay. I think I can get two flame swords. Let's go ahead and shoot this. This might be cheating, but oh well. Whoever designed this maze, this is a really cool maze. Like, kudos to you for putting this in the game. There's so much cool stuff in this game. Pretty awesome. Alright, come up here. Oh, it's gone. Why is it gone? There's just nothing on this side? There's a flame sword on the other side, but there's nothing on this side? Unless it just got reset. Wait. Oh, wait, this might be the path I took. I'm really confused. Hold on, give me a second. Oh, I dropped down from above, right? Okay, so I think both paths... Yeah, I just went to the right side and it took me back down to the same path. Okay, I'm starting to understand. There might have been three total paths. Wow. Alright. I'm just kind of looking, seeing if there's anything else I want to explore. I don't think so. I don't even think there's a way to get out of here. Like, once you're done, you have to teleport. Like, the only way to get here is to fly all the way across the map, or to teleport. There's an upward stream. Whee! Wait, why did I do this? I just now thought about what I was doing, and I was just like, I could just teleport. I don't have to go back to land if I don't want to. There's a raft. This is just awesome. This is like something you would find in Minecraft. Not something that is just randomly put into a game, like a AAA game the size of Zelda. Really cool that they decided to put this here. Might be some cool stuff here. Yep. So, if you've been following my Let's Play, 10 of these stones equals a diamond, which is 500 gold, so that's actually really cool that we found luminous stones here. And that's not cool. Nothing here? Oh yeah, there is. Okay, cool. Another freaking tree spirit. Korok. Just dropped a rock on his head. Alright, is there any more? Oh yeah, there's a couple more. Never know what you're gonna find. All the way out in the middle of nowhere. You know, I might actually have 10 in my inventory. Let's check. I do, I have exactly 10. So I can trade these in for 500 money. Should I do that now? I mean, maybe. I'd have to go all the way back to... Wait. I'd have to go to here, the Zora's Domain, and then I can trade with some guy. There's actually a side quest I want to try out real quick. One of the side quests says to just dive, and I don't really understand what that means, but we'll check it out. I also want to trade in these 10 rocks for 500 money, because we're kind of low on money. We're at 1,500. I mean, we're not really low, but I feel like we could always use more money. So I can't go to the volcano yet, so I'm going to have to figure out what I'm supposed to do. I think I'm going to travel to a different area and maybe fight a different divine beast that doesn't require you to have any resistance. Might as well cook a couple things. Hasty meat skewer. 3 lightning bolts. That must make you move like super fast. Do I have any rock salts? Oh, I do. Way over here. Oh, look at this. Raw prime meat. Let me sort the inventory. Big radish. Increase your maximum hearts. Raw prime meat. Let's put a couple of rock salt and maybe some little meat. See what this does. Full recovery plus 5. That wasn't anything too special, I don't think. I love just throwing in just a random pot of nonsense and getting something good. Simmered fruit. It's weird that I got a simmered fruit from that. Oh, that means something good? Seriously? Cream of vegetable soup. Okay. Okay, done with that. So what was I gonna do? I was gonna go talk to this guy, who I think will trade me... Here are the stones. I have to count them. Diamond. Okay. So there's another side quest here that I forgot to do. It's called Diving is a Beauty. Everyone knows a feet first dive isn't all that beautiful, so dive in head first. So I'm supposed to go up here and talk to some guy. Another thing I wanted to do, there's so many things I need to do in this game. There's just like, it's just a never ending amount of like side quests and just stuff. Ooh. Okay, so I'm supposed to wear this armor, and I'm just supposed to dive. That was not a dive. How do you dive? Whee. Oh wait, I know. Maybe I have to do something like that, maybe? I'm gonna have to look this up. Hold on, give me a second. Oops. No, 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 no. Okay. How to dive in Breath of the Wild. Or the Zora tunic and jump off a ledge into water. Maybe you have to stand on a ledge and do it? That didn't work. I'm confused. How do you die? It just says... Oh, there we go. There's a dive. Perfect. You just have to just press a jump button, that's it. I bet you not too many people have this helmet that I have on. That's all he gave me? I don't care about that. Man, that was a waste of time. And then, let's see, what else was there? I'm just like looking through like stuff that I can do. You know what? Instead of wasting time doing shrines and stuff, I am going to... Where's my adventure log? Let's go to the main quest. I'm kind of curious what this is. I'll do that later. Four divine beasts. Okay. So obviously I can't do the volcano one now because I freaking catch on fire. Freaking die. So I'll have to go to a different one. I'll try going to this one. I feel like I've barely accomplished anything in Zelda, and I'm like, what, maybe 17 hours into the game? Maybe even more than that, probably 18 hours now. I mean, that's just crazy to think about that. Being like 18 hours into the game and only killing one out of the five main bosses, I mean, that's just insane. I'm trying to think how long this is going to take to beat this game. Maybe 50 hours? Which is, it's great. I mean, I'm having lots of fun. This game's amazing. But I'm just thinking, like, how long is this gonna take me? Oh, it's cold up here. Hold on. Hold on, hold on. I know you're freezing your butt off. Let me get my inventory. Get my, my special clothing on. Alright, I'm good. Okay, so I'm all the way back at, like, the beginning area of the game. Uh-oh. That means I need to switch weapons. Okay. So I'm heading this way. I can already see a shrine, so we're gonna head straight to that shrine. There's like... some giant thing down here. You see that? Oh, never mind. That's just one of those goblin camps. I thought that was something else. Yeah, I see the shrine. Let's see if I can't land right here. Regain my stamina and look in this well. What could possibly be... Oh. Oh, what is this? What is this? Oh, if I put this in the hole, something will happen. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yep. I knew that was gonna happen. Whoa. Aw, crap. I think you have to use, like, wooden or, like, non-metal stuff against electric stuff. I don't know. I killed him. Regardless. I kind of feel like they should have added dinosaurs to this game. That would be fun. Alright, anyways. Back to the grind. We're going over that way. There's another skull thing. We need to head, I think, up there. Oh, there's a tower up that way. It might not have been the smartest idea to fall all the way down, but we can always teleport back, so it's not a big deal. Give me that prime meat. I don't know what to do. Okay, another puzzle. How many spirit orbs do I have? Two? One. I only have one. Dang. The next time I get four spirit orbs, I'm going to use them on energy. So that I can glide farther, mainly. I guess for other stuff too. Well, maybe I should use it on hearts. I don't know. I don't know. Sometimes I just don't know. Another trial. This trial looks different. Something to do with stasis. How do I go up? This is the, like, weirdest intro I've seen in so long. I think I have to, like, knock the ball into that pit by using stasis and then, like, an arrow. Oh, okay. Every time I come into one of these puzzle rooms, I always think the puzzle is going to be harder than what it actually is. Oh, there's actually enemies here. No point to kill him because I can't get over there anyway. The ball fell off. Alright, now it's time. There's the ball. Oh, you can kill him one hit? I didn't know that. Done. Oh, I see. I was wondering for a second, like, how the heck am I supposed to do this? It's actually real easy. There's a chest on that side, you see it? Oh, wait. How am I supposed to block? How am I supposed to get over there? Maybe I'm supposed to throw it, and then I'm supposed to, like... Oh, I'm supposed to duck. Okay, I'm supposed to, like, throw it over, and then I'm supposed to duck. Wait. Okay. I think here's the deal. Nope. Okay. Got it. This was harder than I thought it was going to be. Alright. We're almost done, but there's a chest that we need to get, so let me just throw this here. Gotta wait for the chest. There's a chest. It may take a little while, but... I'm always eager to find out what's in the chests and treasure rooms or in shrines, because usually you get some good stuff. Almost missed it. Probably arrows. Oh, just an opal. Never mind. Not really that good. Done. That was a pretty fun, like, puzzle chamber. That was, pretty cool. Different from what I experienced before in other puzzle rooms. So that's a plus. I like how there was three chambers in that room. Usually these puzzle rooms are very, very short. This one was kind of longer just because there was three different chambers. It's kind of like doing three puzzles. Alright, got the spirit orb. Hooray. I feel like this game was intended to allow the player to just play forever. Like, I feel like there's just so much stuff to do. It's crazy. You could play this game for like a month straight. If you want to explore the entire map, like every inch of the map, it'll be playing for so long every day, like 5 hours a day for a month. How long is that? 150 hours, I think. Alright, now the question is, what do we do now? We need to get all the way up there. I don't have a horse. I could climb this mountain. Maybe. Maybe not. Just looking at everything, I'm just thinking like, oh, I don't want to do this. I'm thinking the best course of action right now is to teleport back to here. And then glide down once again and try to get on a higher platform. I think that would be faster than just trying to like run somewhere. Because I can't climb that cliff, I don't think, anyway. I don't think I have enough energy for that. Trying to force a rowdy and untamed horse to speed up will likely result in being tossed to the ground. Horse temperaments. Kind of wish I had like a super fast horse that can run forever. I love that skeleton horse that we got that one time. That thing was awesome. Alright. So now we have like a little bit better picture. So there's the tower. Are we gonna get to the tower? To get to the tower, you have to climb this entire thing. Man. I don't know. So I'm gonna try to make it all the way across to where I went before, But instead of jumping down, I'm gonna go like a different direction. We went there before on that triangle. There's a bunch of like scaffold. What is it called? Scaffolding? Scaffolding? I forgot what that word was. Like all across here. The thing is, I want to go all the way up. So where would I need to go all the way up? I'm guessing I would need to go all the way to the right. And there's like a... Oh shit. Another one of these. Crap, I almost hit him. He doesn't do that much damage. I'm thinking maybe I should use like, I don't know, maybe like a good weapon. I'm kind of saving that weapon though. Maybe I should use some good arrows, like maybe a better arrow. Maybe an ice arrow would be better. It actually kind of sucks because the thing is on his butt. Alright, I need to change weapon types. Well, there's no point to climb up it if it's just on his butt. Oh my god. That did a lot of damage. I need to heal. Oh wait, and I can also wear my better gear. Actually, I want to keep wearing this because it gives me attack up. Here, I got an idea. How about I use an explosive arrow? Maybe that'll do more damage. Yeah, they did a lot of damage, actually. The trick to this game is just to show no fear against these bosses. I think it maybe I can just hit it. No. Oh, I got an idea. Maybe I can do like a jumping down thrust. No, that didn't work. I was trying to hit. You saw what I was trying to do. Okay. This guy's annoying. You have to like wait for him to attack to have an opportunity to hit this thing. Alright, one more hit. That took a while. That took a lot longer than it should have, but we barely took any damage, and that was actually pretty easy. And I think it dropped... I thought I was gonna drop a diamond, but I guess not. Lame. So I think it expects us to go all the way down that way and then to climb upwards. At that point, and then you can climb all the way up. Maybe I can just run over this way instead. I mean, I'm supposed to be going that way to get to the tower, but I need to find some way to scale up this cliff. Place is huge. Yeah, right here. I can just go across. No big deal. There's probably like a bottom path too. Oh wait, I need some climbing gear. Where's my climbing? There it is. Climbing vest. You know, I might actually be able to climb all the way up. Did not even think about that. Yeah, I can just climb straight up. I didn't think I had the stamina to go all the way up. But it looks like I do. Sweet. Done. Does this boomerang ever degrade? Because I've used it so much. Like, I've used it a lot. And it hasn't ever shown any signs of degrading. It's kind of strange. I'm gonna keep making my way upwards. Good thing I have plenty of energy. Double kill. Raw gourmet meat. Some of the Link's noises. Oh crap. I did not mean to do that. Like what kind of grunt is that? Okay. This time don't fall. And there's a chest up here. I'm just gonna go check it out. I wonder if you can burn this like thing down. Probably not. But I think there might be. What is this? Nothing? It's just a perch. This is like a really like not as appealing area as the places I've been before in the game. It's just like a big desert. Let's go check out that tree. It's like the only tree in this desert, so there has to be something here, right? Probably something at top, on top. Probably one of those little guys on top. There's a flame fairy. Yeah, there's something up here. Yep. Gonna copy and paste it of something I found earlier. Like, I knew that was gonna happen, because that same exact tree was in another part of the game. They do a lot of copy and paste in this game. You find like the same type of creatures in multiple different areas. Up we go. Those textures look so bad on the side of cliffs. I wonder if there's another one of those guys in one of these trees. You think? There's an electric lizard. And this is why I have a boomerang. Oh, the giant boomerang broke. Dang it. I guess it had its moment. Oops. Steel lizard bow. Okay, I have a lot of bows now. I can drop a couple maybe. Let's drop this one. Let's It's the first yellow lizard I've fought. Is this thing alive? No. There's a fairy, though. Got it. So I'm pretty sure the fairies heal you if you have, like, less than 10% health. So those are kind of cool. Alright, screw that. Am I even going the right way? I lost track of the tower. I think it's right in front of me, but I'm not entirely certain. See some minerals over here. Oh, peppers! Lots of peppers. And a sapphire. That's worth like 250. So I'm gonna climb right here. Uh-oh. Was not expecting that. I think I'm just gonna outrun him. I could kill him. But do I want to kill him? Not really. But there's a chest back there, so if I do kill him, I will get something. Let's kill him. Got nothing better to do. Well, what weapons do I have? I don't have much. I have a flame sword. Should I try a flame sword? Ouch. This is a really cool weapon. Alright, I'm going back. I should have more arrows. Dropped it. Why did I drop it? I accidentally dropped the blade. I really think I should be saving this flame blade for like a boss that's weak against fire. But whatever. I mean, we don't got a whole lot of options here. In the middle of the desert. Topaz? I don't know why I picked that up. Okay, we're almost to the tower, and then we can find out where to go from there. Are they sleeping? Alright, we're there. Oh no, there's... We're gonna have to, like, glide to it. Oh wait, there's two pillars. So there's three pillars that I have to climb first on this side. There's a bunch of blocks that we can use. To make a pathway. Oh, they broke? What happened? A wild berry. It just... Oh. Okay, it works. It just... It seemed like it didn't work at first. This is just, like, very deep waters. Alright, I think maybe one more will do it. As far out as I can go. Okay. Alright, that should be fine. Oh, it drowned. I'm gonna have to go back out. This is really stupid. I really kind of hate how many puzzles are in the game. Like, you would think just the journey alone would be enough, but they have to make climbing the tower such a chore as well. Alright, finally. There we go. And now we need to climb this. There we go, Wasteland Tower. Should take us no time at all to get up here. Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Almost out of stamina. There we go. I am Link. I blush. Why is he blushing? He has, like, red marks on his face. Maybe he's just sunburned. Oh, that was cool. Alright, made it. I think I'm freezing right now. Why is Link's ear pierced? I just now realized that. I mean, I don't mean that in a bad way. I'm just wondering, like, does that mean something? His left ear is pierced. Map revealed. Hooray! This area is huge. I just now realized how big this area was. I guess it gets cold in the desert at night, just like in real life. So we'll have to wear this. Okay, so. I need to go this way. To that village way out in the distance. Yeah, let's go ahead and head that way. There's the divine beast. You see it? It almost looks exactly the same as the elephant. It's the camel. There's also a shrine. Crap. How am I gonna get to that shrine? Okay, so there's a shrine right in front of- Oh, there's two shrines. Sweet. And there's also a stable. Alright. Two shrines and a stable. Very nice, very nice. So we'll go ahead and complete this shrine, and then I'll probably go over to the other shrine after I get a horse, and then we'll see about how we can kill that divine beast. This might be the second beast we kill. I actually feel like we're making significant progress now. I feel like if I just stick on the main story quest line, I can get through this game very quickly. But I keep getting distracted with side quests and shrines and all sorts of good stuff. I mean, shrines are useful. Shrines, you have to do shrines to get your hearts up and your energy up. But, ooh, what is going on here? This is just an electric one. Yeah, I don't have any arrows. I wish I had more arrows because I'm like almost out. I'm having to waste like good arrows. Sucks. Oh well. Next time we make a pit stop, we have to buy arrows. Oh wait, that goes to the chest? I thought that would go to the exit. Small key. Unlocks doors inside shrines. It's the first time I've seen a key. Yay, Guardian Sword. Okay, what the heck is going on here? Oh, it's another current. It's a, you gotta connect it to, I think. So, I need to use this. There we go. That was the easiest thing ever. That wasn't even really a puzzle. That was just like super easy. Is there any other chests? I guess there wasn't any chests in this shrine. Kind of weird. There might have been one. There was one area I didn't check, but I don't really care right now. That seemed like a really easy puzzle, so I'm not gonna worry too much about it. Do 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 do. Is any good? Probably not. I just killed that dog. Well, I got one arrow. Okay. So I don't know why I was wasting time over there. I was just looking for gems. But we can go down here now to the stable. Ooh. Rush rooms. Oh, that hurt. Another side quest. I'm not gonna do the side quest, I just wanted to pick it up. I'm just looking here. Beetle sells insects. This guy has a quest. This guy wants rush rooms. Buddy, you know the deal was for 55. I have no use for a random number of rush rooms. If you want to deal with me, bring me 55 rush rooms. 55? No way. Like, these are rush rooms. I have to get 55 of these? Are you kidding me? That's crazy. It's like every freaking mushroom in the whole area. I mean, just looking, there's a bunch of mushrooms like all over the place, but I'm sorry, I'm not gonna collect 55. I only have like 5 currently. look at those pretty horses. You know, I think it would be awesome if you could buy horses with money. It's kind of surprising that you can't. What does bored horse mean? No. Horsey! I wish there was like a general store here as well. There's like no general stores. I mean, this guy has... I'm pretty sure... Oh, he has arrows, okay. I thought he just had bugs. Usually he just sells bugs. How much will all of them cost? 120? Wow. Okay, so I have some stuff I want to sell to this guy. I have a bunch of diamonds. There we go. Now I'm rich. I can also sell these sapphires. Yay! Oh, I have a bunch of these. I always like to keep one, because I think these gems... I think you can use them later on in the game. I'm not sure where. But I know I can use them somewhere. I'm freaking rich now. Look how much money I have. 5,000. First time I had 5,000. Wow. Alright, I'm done. Get me out of here. Get me out of here. And I guess, should I do some cooking before we leave? No, there's... You know what? I think I'm just gonna end this episode here. And I'm gonna do a little bit of cooking. And next episode, we'll find the next shrine, and then we'll go to that city, and we'll fight the divine beast. Should be a lot of fun. Before we do that, though, let's go ahead and do a little bit of cooking. A bunch of spicy peppers. Raise your body temperature and help you withstand the cold. Oops. I just dropped all this on the ground accidentally. Okay, what was I even wanting to put in the pot? Spicy pepper steak. Nice. Salty grilled prime steak. saw grilled gourmet meat. Cook it to recover more hearts. I'm gonna do 5 of these giant steaks. This should probably heal like a ton. Meat skewer, yeah, that definitely heals like a crazy amount, way more than I even need. Okay, I want to do some elixirs too. Hasty elixir. Like, I haven't found anything, like, anything at all. Kind of vitality makes it highly valued in elixirs. No. Okay, I think we're done. Well, I don't know. Maybe I should try this. I'm thinking maybe I can, like, put... Let me see if a snake tail and an eyeball work together. Nope. Because they're both monster parts. Yeah. Alright, well, I think we're done. So, I think I'm going to end this episode here. And the next episode, we'll go to another shrine, and we'll go fight that sand divine beast. So, thanks for watching, and have a nice day.